When I worry about the world, or my faith in humankind falters, I paint something. Wall, paper, object, myself. I have painted so many things. Again and again, like a child's prayer. A naive, unruly hope that a brave spot of color can stem the loss. When I fear that these fragile gestures, unsupported in the wild, will be overwhelmed, which is always, I scatter, like milkweed silk on summer's breeze, piles of paintbrushes for younger hands to find. Every time startled anew at the fierce authority with which they seize them. Intuitive. Unafraid. Alight with imagination. When I see this spontaneous grace, this sheer joy of making, as natural as water flowing home, I can imagine once more that one solitary spot may multiply boldly and become many, countless, a brilliant torrent, exhilarating, as powerful as the ocean is wide. You, fresh and undimmed, I would protect you like precious sprouts, preserve you ever untouched by the faintest shadow of grief. If only such fierce desires and swaths of paint alone would suffice to prepare you for the long work ahead. Forgive me my imperfect prayers. Forgive us this imperfect world. I wish for you that when you are buffeted by difficult winds, they blow just fiercely enough that you come to value stillness, ever alert to the blessings that surround you like a wild profusion of birdsong. And to rattle your heart open, so that joy in simple things may nest profoundly in its thickets. I wish that you taste just enough bitter adversity for compassion to spill over into you like luxuriant vines, weaving their roots so deeply they cannot be torn out. And to seed in your soul such gratitude and abundance that you share your riches with the glorious abandon of flowering fields. I wish that you are pierced just deeply enough by fear and loneliness to labor as you can for every breathing soul to feel safe and cherished. Secured as tightly as the barnacles bind their tiny kingdoms to the rocks, and are drawn with curiosity and admiration to things unlike yourself, as the strange and brilliant populations of coral reefs gather in their boundless diversity. I wish that you are struck just enough by ruin and loss to know that you must carry the sacred, fragile earth and its creatures as gently as a great river carries a leaf, honoring your responsibilities towards them with a generosity of spirit as deep as the roots of the mountains. I wish that you are chastened often enough, stung by deception and cruelty just enough, that your soul swings towards right deeds as unerringly as a flock of swifts steers towards magnetic north, and to learn to give and receive kindness and love as softly as the thermal draft holds the circling sparrow. And lastly, I wish that when your heart breaks, as it surely will, it draws you closer to others and to the vast ecosystem of creation, like breathing in the scent of endless forests, and to the vision of a complete, verdant, and lasting peace, as magnificent as the stars blazing across the heavens. You, vibrant and delicate as the first unfolding tendrils of spring, these are my prayers for you. Only enough hardship as it takes, and not a fraction more, for you to arise, wise, strong, and determined to take this damaged world and paint it into a rainbow nation for all living things.